2020 started off big. We went to the world's largest gathering on urban issues, the 10th World Urban Forum. We championed young voices to be at the heart of important discussions. We catalyzed dialogue for change and new partnerships were formed. Then the pandemic hit the world, but we did not stop. We listened, adapted, and carried on. We took big steps for the Our City initiative. We gave it a name and shared our dream and vision for our key commitment to creating inclusive cities and brighter futures for young people.
The need and the opportunity of including young people in urban development continues to be a major blind spot for decision makers at all levels. And therefore, to connect, collaborate, and act with young people living in urban environments through catalyzing stakeholders and fostering collaborative city platforms is important for the creation of healthy and happy cities fit for young people.
We convened and launched the first phase of IDAR, which is the International Digital Health and AI Research Collaborative, with a diverse range of stakeholders.
IDAR is an international research collaborative to answer essential questions to deploy and exploit digital and AI technologies in an inclusive way for better health. Imagine you are a young person in a slum of a fast-growing city in a resource-limited setting. What does it need for you to also have access to these services?
We inspired young people from around the world with the Future Cities Challenge, together with UN Habitat. That gave young people the opportunity to voice their needs and ideas for the future of our cities.
We look forward to launching an edition in 2021 to continue to harness ideas of young people.
Further, we continue to support and fund research and innovation projects to improve the health and well-being of young people in growing urban environments around the world. On behalf of the entire foundation, a big thanks to all our fantastic partners for your hard work despite disruptions during the pandemic.